because the purpose is for what? A change of destiny. The end is for blessing. It doesn't matter. Maybe I'm...
Declaring God's praise and prophecies. This is the call and commission of the Diana Edu Ministries. And that's why we're still ahead. It's all about the kingdom. For more details, please visit our website. That's www.gospelfragrance.info.
Believe in the prophet and you will prosper. Believe in God and you will be established.
Now to the prophetic word you've been waiting for. Ascoltiamo la parola di Dio.
Hi, God bless you. Last week, I gave you evidences that blood speaks, and it is only the blood of God that speaks positively for us. Amen.
Shalom, shalom. Que Signore vi benedica. Domenica scorso abbiamo capito che il sangue parlano e abbiamo capito anche che è soltanto il sangue di Dio che parla benedizione.
The theme is the blood of Elohim.
La tema è il sangue di Elohim.
But I want you to underline just the blood of Eli, your Eli.
Ma voglio che vi sottolineate soltanto il sangue di Eli.
I don't know who is your Eli. Eli means father. Elohim means father God.
Non so chi è vostro Eli. Eli vuol dire padre, ma Elohim vuol dire che padre Dio.
You and I bear witness that like father, like son. What you are is the fruit you bear. An orange does not bear mango fruits. And so, who you are is the children you birth.
Così, io e te sappiamo che tale è padre, tale figlio, tale madre, tale figlia. Ciò che siamo, abbiamo preso dai nostri genitori biologici.
Many times people go through psychological, numerological, and economical, emotional, and whole lot of turmoils just because it was hand down. Bronywe will hand down documents and properties and hereditary from generation to generation.
Molte persone subiscono problemi psicologici, problemi finanziari, divorzio, e tanti altri problemi.
It is the blood of their Eli that is speaking against them.
E molto spesso anche nella vita dei genitori o i nonni hanno subito le stesse cose. Quindi molto della sofferenza delle persone è il sangue del casa di loro genitori che sta gridando contro di loro.
A lot of people know that about the ninth hour in Matthew chapter 27 verse 46, Jesus cried out with a loud voice saying, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani. Which means, my God, why have you forsaken me? Eli, Eli, we have made songs out of it, but this morning I'm here to unveil to you the mystery behind why Christ did not say Eloi, which was the normal language he should have spoken, but he said Eli in the Aramaic, which means what?
Father.
God.
Sì, e poi come abbiamo visto, sta scritto in Matteo 27, 40, 46. Gesù Cristo sulla croce ha gridato dicendo Eli, Eli, lama sabatani, cioè Dio mio, perché mi hai abbandonato? Oggi siamo qui a svelare il significato
why
di questo qui.
Why he said Eli and not Elohi?
E poi siamo qui a spiegare perché Gesù non ha detto Elohi ma diceva Eli.
Ninth hour is a time of trouble.
Gesù gridava durante il nono ora. Il nono ora è l'ora del guaio.
Spiritual warfare, darkness.
Nono ora ha da fare con l'ora di buio.
A time of crisis.
L'ora di crisi, l'ora di battaglia spirituale.
In this time of crisis, people like to kill their wives or blame their children.
In questa ora di crisi, molte persone stanno uccidendo i loro mogli e stanno accusando i loro figli.
They harass people around them and blame people for the cause of their crisis.
Moro tanti cercano di attribuire loro crisi agli altri.
Some also like Christ in their ninth hour because Christ took upon himself our nature. This means that on the cross, on the ninth hour, there are some people who cry to Eli, Eli.
Ma come Cristo ci sono anche alcuni che durante il loro momento Jesus. Di crisi loro gridano Eli, Eli.
In your time of crisis and darkness, who are you crying to?
Nel tuo tempo di crisi, a chi stai gridando? A chi stai gridando?
Look, when Christ was calling on Eli, Eli, some people that were there said, "This man is calling on Elijah."
E poi anche quando Cristo gridava, gridava, Eli, Eli, c'erano persone intorno che dicevano, "Guarda, lui sta chiamando Elia."
This means these people used to call Elijah in their time of crisis.
Vuol dire che questi personaggi probabilmente durante la loro crisi chiamavano Elia.
Who is Elijah?
Chi è Elia?
He might be a saint of somebody in our days.
Elia era un grande profeta, ma nel nostro tempo potrebbe essere un santo, uno che ha fatto tanti miracoli.
And who is now being worshipped by men.
Ma viene adorato dagli uomini.
And sometimes when they pray to him, he answers.
E a volte quando gli uomini pregano a Elia,
but this time,
lui dava
Jesus
risposta.
Did not call Elijah.
Ma questa volta, ma Gesù durante il momento di sua crisi non ha chiamato Elia.
Some people say that. They said, "Leave him alone and let's see if Elijah will come and save him." These are the ones who know that it is not always the time you call Elijah that Elijah comes to save you.
E poi anche alcune persone intorno a lui dicevano che vediamo se verrà Elia veramente a liberarlo.
I have a story about a man who was in crisis and called on Saint something of Padova. And when the saints came, the saints said, "No, I am the one of Napoli, Saint Antonio. So which saints were you calling?" And the saints left the person and the person fell down.
Abbiamo anche sentito delle storie di persone che durante il momento di crisi gridavano, chiamavano Sant'Antonio. E questa persona era a Padova e poi si è apparso un santo, una certa Sant'Antonio. E dice che io sono Sant'Antonio di Napoli, ma tu... Sei a Padova, Padova Sant'Antonio stai chiamando.
Oh.
E lui era confuso.
In your time that you feel that everybody has forsaken you and you don't know where to turn your head, who do you call? Eli, Eli. Eli meant a father to somebody. Eli meant Elijah to somebody. But to Jesus Christ, Eli meant God. That is the meaning of the Aramaic word, God.
Sì, Eli, come vediamo nella Bibbia, per persone intorno a Gesù, per loro Gesù chiamava Elia. Ma per alcune persone Eli è magari un altro santo uomo. Ma per Cristo, Eli è Dio.
The word Eli also means father.
Ma la parola Eli vuol dire anche padre.
The Bible says in the book of 1 Kings chapter 2 that there is a priest whose name is called Abiathar.
Sì, nel libro di Secondo Re c'è una prete con nome Abiathar.
The Bible says that he followed a rebellion.
La Bibbia dice che lui ha seguito una ribellione.
And all the people who were in the rebellion were killed.
E tutte le persone che erano quel gruppo, quella ribellione sono state uccise.
But he was set free by King Solomon.
Ma lui è stato risparmiato dal re Solomone.
The Bible says that King Solomon said, "Depart to Anathoth." Anathoth is a city of refuge. It is the place of the altar, the horns of the altar. Put, he says, to your own field, because he was a priest, and Anathoth was also a city for the priest. So he said, "Go to Anathoth, because you bore the ark of my father David. And because of this, you shall not die." Listen to me. When you go to verse 27, if you read your own, Bible says, "And yet Solomon removed Abiathar the priest from being a priest, so that the curses that were spoken upon Abiathar's father, Eli, might be fulfilled." In this scripture, we understand that in the time of crisis of this man, the voice of his Eli rather worsened his situation. He was not killed, but he was demoted. Many people are in Casa Integrazione. Many people have been demoted. How many people are connecting it to the voice of their father's house that is crying demotion against them. Many people who used to be wealthy for the past 20 years are now begging. Have you ever wondered that your great-grandfather was cursed with begging? The Bible says that the curse on the house of Eli had to do with what? Begging. And Abiathar was removed from the priest's office. When they remove you, pastor, from the priest's office, it means you will now lack bread, because bread belonged to the priest. And so Abiathar started to beg. Many people who were working in factories are now begging for a penny to buy food for their children. How many of you have connected it to what? The voice of your enemy that is speaking against you.
Se oggi siamo qui a dire che molto delle sofferenze delle persone è dovuto alla voce del sangue della casa dei loro genitori. E proprio questo prete in questione, Abiathar, è stato licenziato dal re Salomone, è stato licenziato di essere prete, di andare a andare a fare contadino.
No, pastor, è stato risparmiato dalla morte.
Sì, sua vita è stato risparmiato, ma licenziato dal lavoro, prete. È stato mandato nel villaggio di diventare contadino. Perché? Perché tutto questo qua è accaduto, è successo perché c'è già una maledizione generazione in casa del padre di Abiathar.
Era la voce.
Quindi questa maledizione non ha avuto effetto affinché quel giorno che Abiathar ha preso posizione con nemici di Salomone.
I want you to use the word voice. It was the voice of his father that was speaking against him.
La voce del sangue della casa di Abiathar gridava contro di lui, di fare la cosa sbagliata.
I like Abiathar's
story.
Because Abiathar is like most of us. We have been delivered from death. You know, Abiathar's generation were all killed because of the voice of Eli that was hanging over them. Abiathar's father was killed. He's like you and I. Jesus has saved us from death. Maybe your grandfather was begging. He begged before he died. Maybe your grandmother begged before he died. You have been saved from the spirit of death. You will go to heaven. But here on earth, why have you come to poverty and why are you begging? Have you ever thought that it is the voice of your Eli that is speaking against you?
See, Abiathar representa un santo uomo perché era un prete, quindi Abiathar rappresenta, diciamo oggi, i figli di Dio. Comunque c'è questa voce del sangue del casa di suo padre che gridava sempre contro di lui.
È come
un credente di oggi, come un cristiano, un vero cristiano di oggi, che tu sei salvato, destinato al paradiso di Dio, ma su questa terra stai soffrendo. La causa è dovuta alla voce, la voce che ti sta gridando
contro te. The blood of Eli, which Jesus called to come and redeem you. Listen, Jesus called Eli, and the word there means God. This was the voice of Eli that was speaking against this man. Eli was a father, but he was a human. That is why Jesus didn't call Elijah. That is why Jesus didn't call Moses. Because he knew that blood questions are dealt with by only Father God. And so he called God. God, why have you forsaken me? Stop calling for your enemies and look for Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani. This is the prophetic word that I heard ringing in my spirit this morning. God says that if you will cry out at the altar and call on him, he will come and save you from the voice of your Eli. Hallelujah.
Se vediamo l'esempio di Cristo, proprio durante il momento del suo crisi, lui non ha chiesto aiuto da nessuno, ma lui ha gridato soltanto al Padre Eterno, solo lui è in grado di spezzare qualsiasi sangue, perché durante il momento di crisi molti chiedono aiuto dal loro genitore biologico, ma dalla casa del genitore biologico c'è soltanto sangue che gridano contro di noi. Ma
this is why the remedy of these voices that are speaking to you against you is only the blood of Jesus. Look, Bible says that at the process of time, when Cain did not apply the blood, we are in the process of time, the beginning of the year. God always comes through his prophet to tell you, apply the blood, because this is the time that the voice of the enemies speak against us. He says, the voice of your brother, because Cain killed his brother. And when he killed him, he thought everything was okay. But God says, the voice of your brother cries out to me from the ground for vengeance. And because of this, you are cursed. That is why I'm telling you that the voices of your father's house and your mother's house only cry out curses against you.
Si so vediamo anche c'è la storia di Caino e Abele. Abbiamo sentito che secondo la Bibbia Caino ha ucciso il suo fratellino. E secondo la Bibbia sta scritto che il sangue di Abele gridava vendetta, perché Abele è morto, ma la Bibbia dice che suo sangue, il sangue di Abele, sì, il sangue di Abele gridava contro Caino. E vediamo che veramente la vita di Caino è stata una vita maledetta.
He himself says that when he goes to look for a work, nobody wanted to give it to him.
Perché lui stesso proclamava che sua vita è maledetta.
He said wherever he goes, he has done nothing. People want to kill him.
Perché lui stesso
diceva. People hated him for no reason.
Lui stesso diceva che la gente intorno a lui volevano ucciderlo.
And when he called for Eli, Eli.
Ma quando Caino ha gridato a Dio,
yes,
Eli,
Caino Eli, called for God and said, God, have mercy on me.
Ma anche Caino ha gridato a Dio che abbia pietà su di me.
And how did God shut the voice of his Eli?
Ma come Dio ha silenziato?
He came to mark him with the blood.
Dio è venuto a macchiare Caino con il sangue.
And so all through the New Old Testament, there is the city of refuge, or the horns of the altar. These were the two places where when a man was being chased because he had inadvertently killed, he was what? His life was saved. Hallelujah.
Sì, quindi se vediamo nell'Antico Testamento, c'è sempre un luogo, se che siamo la città di rifugio, dove se una persona per incidente magari uccide una persona, lui, questa persona scappa lì e lì sua vita viene risparmiata finché vive in
quella città. So God did not leave us helpless for the blood of our enemies to just throw us here and there, tossing us, making our life frustrated. They say now in psychiatry, you don't even have a place. Foreigners are being filled there. Italians are being filled there because we live in a time of the ninth hour where all we have to do is do like Jesus. The key is calling, Eli, Eli. Because behind all this, a voice of the Father's house is crying out against somebody.
Ma noi dobbiamo capire che nonostante le situazioni del mondo, le crisi che c'è in mondo, Dio non ha abbandonato il mondo, ma ha sempre una città di rifugio, un posto dove c'è riposo, possiamo riposare in pace.
Adonijah was the one himself who started the rebellion, and Solomon was after his life. He ran to the horns of the altar, and Solomon said, if there is no guilt in you, you will live. Go home. Because he held to the horns of the altar, the voice of his father's house, which says that there would be bloody death between brothers, was saved. Why? Because he cried out at the horns of the altar, which is what? The voice of thanksgiving. He called out to God, and God gave him remedy. He gave him life.
Ma anche quando vediamo la vita di Adonijah, perché lui era sotto la sentenza della morte, ma lui è scappato nel tempio e ha preso la corona dell'alleanza. E lì è stato risparmiato.
You say, what is the corona of the alleanza? In Psalm 26, he says that, I will wash my hands in innocence, and I'll go round your altar with the voice of thanksgiving. Hallelujah. So the voice of thanksgiving. When you are in crisis, please control yourself and stop harassing your children and murmuring. You are only worsening your situation. Go around the altar with the voice of thanksgiving. This is the voice that will shut the voice of your Elis. Eli,
amen,
Eli,
amen.
La
amen.
Marx,
adesso abbiamo un minuto per chiudere, quindi sentiamo Let's consider that it's cambio divino que Cristo
ci ha procurato. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Pastor. And so the Bible says that Christ has redeemed us from the curse.
La Bibbia dice che Gesù Cristo ci ha liberato della maledizione che proviene dalla casa dei nostri genitori.
I want to underline that no man has that power to deliver you from the voice of the blood.
Secondo la Bibbia, nessuno uomo è in grado di liberarci dalla maledizione, ma solo Gesù.
Christ was punished that you might be forgiven.
Cristo è stato punito sulla croce affinché tu sei liberato.
Christ was wounded that you might be healed.
Cristo è stato sfigurato affinché tu avrai guarigione.
Christ's blood was made sinful that you will receive his precious blood to walk in holiness, worthiness, and righteousness.
Il sangue di Cristo è stato macchiato affinché tuo sangue diventerà una sangue retta.
Christ died that you might live.
Cristo ha subito la morte affinché tu avrai sua
Christ
vita.
Christ became poor that you might be rich.
Cristo è diventato povero affinché tu diventerai ricco.
Christ bore your shame that you would bear his glory.
Cristo ha subito la tua vergogna affinché tu avrai la il
Christ,
suo
like
gloria.
Christ, like Abel, was rejected, but so that you might be accepted.
Cristo è stato negato, abbandonato affinché tu avrai accoglienza favorevole
Christ
davanti
a Dio e
uomini.
Christ became a curse that you might receive the blessing of God.
Cristo ha subito la tua maledizione affinché tu avrai la benedizione di Dio.
He is the only one to sustain you in this time of crisis.
È solo lui in grado di sostenerti
in questo
momento
of
di
darkness.
Crisi. Nel momento
and
de,
that
del
is
buio.
Why he says that at the time of famine you shall laugh.
Ecco perciò lui dice che nel momento di mancanza tu
riderai. Order for this book and call out to him. Eli, Eli, pray with me. Eli.
Pregate Eli, con noi. Eli, 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 Eli,
Eli. La mag sabat
Eli, sabat, sabat.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Grazie,
let the voice of the blood of God speak
let
for you.
Let the voice of the blood of Jesus, Jesus speak for
name.
Us in the name
Amen.
Of Jesus. Amen.
God richly
che Signore vi benedica.
Thank you for watching. We hope to have been a blessing to you and your house. If you'd like to know more about this ministry, please write to us at gospelfragrance@yahoo.it or visit us at www.gospelfragrance.info. And please don't forget to support the Diana Edu Ministries worldwide. Till we meet next time, God richly bless you.